Yeah, I think so. So look, the first half of my career, I was a naval warfare officer on board Her Majesty's Canadian ship Algonquin and then Vancouver. And that is a very it's a very demanding job. So those are the primary leaders on board Canada's warships. They lead the watch on deck. They're responsible for the safety and security of 200 of their shipmates, and they have to become proficient in several warfare areas so that if they ever are in a conflict, they can defend and fight the ship appropriately. And along with that came, at the time, I think, a very prescriptive idea of what a good leader was. And a good leader wasn't necessarily a bubbly, feminine energy. It was a hard charging, ball breaking, get her done type of role. And I want to say, like back in the day, some of the things I brought to the table weren't necessarily embraced as typical leadership. And I remember back in the day, so I tried to adapt to what was perceived as that ideal leadership standard. And I really didn't like the person I was becoming because I found like I was becoming sarcastic and sharp and hard-edged. And while I think we should always adapt our personality and adapt our leadership style, I didn't sort of like the general feel that I was left with. And at the end of the day, I kind of had a reckoning with myself, and I am a girly girl. I am bubbly. I care for my people, and I can still do this job. So I sort of tried to let my true self shine through a little bit more rather than sort of defaulting to what was the ideal. And at the end of the day, I think I was fairly successful. I loved, I loved leading sailors on board the ship. I loved working with our engineers in the engine room, and I think I was able to inject the appropriate level of fun to keep the team motivated, without necess once I sort of realized, hey, it's okay if I don't conform. And I don't really think it had a negative impact. I think we sometimes, as leaders, when we're in difficult situations, we care too much about what other people think, or we try to adapt to what we think other people want to think, or what we think other people will want us to be. But you know what? Know who you are and know your strengths, and then lean on those strengths. And I think you can achieve what you set out to be in a fairly successful manner.